started this march towards education for all in 1990 when the world gathered in Jomtien, Thailand, signed the Declaration for Education for All. 10 years later, we sort of checked our progress with another conference in Dakar to see what progress we were making in education for all goals. So what have we done? It is time to assess ourselves as teacher unions in our various countries.
For 25 years, we've been making a lot of promises. And one of the things that has come through is that there's a lot of promise fatigue. And you hear sort of small mentions of teachers as teachers are absent or teachers are on strike. But what they don't tell you is that, and what we've heard, that teachers are teaching under some very difficult circumstances.
How do we help the teacher? Of course we're going to talk about absenteeism, but we forget that teacher has to cross three rivers to go and receive a salary. Not forgetting that you get there and the man who is supposed to process your salary is not even there.
Professionalize the teaching standard, provide enough educational materials, both library and laboratory materials, and even instructional material for the students, textbooks as well. All of these things are lacking right now in most of the schools, especially the rural area.
In certain areas, they don't have schools. So the community have come up with initiative to educate their children. But these community schools, the problem they have is that, you know, the quality of education they are providing is compromised in most cases because they are using teachers who are not trained. They have no methodology to teach the children. The infrastructure which is being used in the community, sometimes they don't even have chairs where they can sit. So learning becomes very, very difficult. In some cases, they even sit under the trees because there isn't enough space in the classroom.
So you start the academic year, you start the term, and you don't have the capitation grant. You don't have any funds to run the school. So you'll be forced to pre-finance all activities in the school until the grants get to the school. So for parents who have their awards in the schools, they have to come and support the school.
There is a shortage of teachers. Despite the government recruiting over 15,000 teachers in the last three years, we still have a critical shortage of teachers. That's why it's even difficult for the government to send trained teachers to help in the community schools, because the public schools still need the teachers.
The government is doing well by distributing free computers, but the problem is the power. How to power these computers where the school does not have money to pay for bills.
Et dans la formation, ces dernières années, on remarque qu'il y a beaucoup de recrutement d'enseignants non qualifiés, des contractuels. Il faut que ça change. Il faut que vraiment qu'on arrête de recruter massivement et non qualitativement.
Il y a un problème de formation continue. Il y a un problème d'adaptation, de contextualisation. Les enseignants doivent être au même diapason du monde qui bouge, du monde qui évolue. Donc il n'y a pas de formation continue régulièrement.
Nous ne pensons pas seulement à nous, à l'amélioration de nos conditions de vie. Nous pensons aussi aux enfants dans les classes. Parfois on se retrouve dans une classe avec 80 élèves. Il faut que vraiment qu'ils soient dans de bonnes conditions d'apprentissage pour qu'ils puissent acquérir plus de connaissances et dans de bonnes conditions.
Nous n'avons pas des innovations pédagogiques stables. À cela, à ces innovations pédagogiques, vous avez une multitude d'écoles privées où le programme officiel n'est pas enseigné. C'est seulement à l'école publique. Et le suivi de ces enseignants au niveau des écoles privées est extrêmement absent.
If you have a class that has 80 pupils and you have 35 minutes to teach a certain topic, it will be difficult to introduce, to give the explanation, and then to see to every child the response on what you have taught.
And indeed, sometimes when it goes through the districts, the district local governments use part of that money to do other business over theirs. And we have cases of teachers ending up not getting their salaries.
La communauté internationale devrait aider les pays africains, les pays sud, au sud de la Méditerranée, des pays comme le Mali, nous devons les aider sans condition, sans condition.
En tant que syndicaliste, le message qu'on voudrait que ça soit entendu au plus haut niveau, entre guillemets, au plus haut niveau, c'est que la profession enseignante, le métier d'enseignant soit revalorisé. qu'on soit écouté, que notre apport soit bénéfique, que ça ne reste pas sur les papiers seulement. Il faut qu'on nous implique plus dans les décisions, dans la politique de l'éducation. Il faut qu'on soit écouté, que notre contribution soit de qualité aussi. Sans l'amélioration des conditions de vie et de travail des enseignants et des enseignantes, il n'y aura pas une éducation de qualité.
The education that we want has been sort of hijacked a little bit. At the global level, you have the World Bank, you have IMF, you have the development banks, and you have others who really see education as a purely technical act. And they are trying to convince ministers of education and ministers of finance to put more money into testing and less money into training. More money into evaluation, less money into infrastructure.
Il faut d'abord que les syndicats s'approprient les vraies politiques, qu'ils les maîtrisent pour être proactifs. C'est aux syndicats d'aller vers le gouvernement et d'insister, de réclamer leur place.
We're trying to see a way of helping children develop their potential as human beings, because it's not about testing for all. It's about education for all, and that's a process.
Les promesses faites à Dakar, que ce soit par la communauté internationale ou par les États parties, ces promesses n'ont pas été tenues, contrairement au discours politique qui dit que l'éducation est la priorité. Il n'y a pas un financement adéquat pour accompagner ces priorités. Et nous ne cesserons jamais de dire que l'éducation est la clé de la sortie de la pauvreté de l'Afrique. Africa, unite.